early Buddhism. See, there is a word called schism. Schism means tukde hona. S-C-H-I-S-M. The schism is very important in any religion, any organized religion. There is difference of opinion, dispute, disagreement, and the factions start appearing, sects start appearing. That process of fissuring or faction is called a fracturing, is called a schism. For example, if I am a Catholic Protestant, Catholic person, and there comes Protestant religion. First come Anglican, Henry VIII, then comes the 95 Theses. So, these are like Protestant revolts against Catholic Church. So, a schism over a church, two tracks. Similarly, in Buddhism also, because you have Sangha, you have unified idea, there is some doctrine. Whenever there is difference, people start to come together or start to go apart. So, sect formation hota hai. Isko Buddhism kehta hai Sangha Bheda. Is that simple? Look at this map, you will get to know what I am talking about. This is a school of Buddhism in various regions, India, Sri Lanka, Tibet, Asia, Central Asia, etc. We don't need all, we need to focus only on India. Their timeline. From the era of Buddha till the early medieval and foundation of Delhi Sultanate. So this is the life of Buddhism in ancient India. This is the entire gamut of ancient India, so to say, after Vedic era. So here we have early Sangha. Early Sangha is the Sangha during and immediately after Buddha's life, in which there is only one Sangha. No factions, all are following the same rules. There is complete agreement over Vinayas. No worries, everything is good and happy. And there is one family. Right? Gradually differences start emerging. And then you have various schools that are coming up. They are called as early Buddhist schools. There are total 18 in number. Conventionally, there can be more or less, we don't know, because 18 numbers don't match. Which is which school? There's a lot of confusion. Not good data is available. And because Indians write in such a way, we don't even know which school was in North India, which in South India, geographical mapping karna mushkil ho jata hai. But we have basic idea of all these schools. So these are 18 schools. So from here, it is after Buddha's life, till here, we have four councils taking place. Four Buddhist councils. Whenever there is dispute, so meeting bulate hai, dispute ko hal kar lete. So that such meeting which is called to resolve dispute, is called as council, and they are called after every few centuries when dispute becomes very important. So we have first council happening immediately after Buddha's life, then second council, third council, fourth council. We'll study the history of councils as well. And during each council, the attempt is made either to resolve the differences or expel the people who don't agree with you. That is the purpose of council, to unify the Sangha and to get it purified of the bad elements. So we have these 18 schools. Of these 18 schools, 17 schools have perished. They are lost. They either diminished or they got assimilated into other schools. The only school out of the 18 that survives today is the one you are asking, Theravada. So senior among. So this is this Theravada, which is continuing like this. Small school. Theravada is not very important in India. It is important historically because it represents the oldest school that is alive today. But if you go by the population of or the adherence to Theravada, it is least in India. It is more popular in Sri Lanka and Southeast Asia. That's where from we brought back our Pali canons also in modern times. So this Theravada is one of the oldest 18 schools that continues like this in modern times. Now after fourth council, which was done by Kanishka, we have in the first century CE, we have emergence of Mahayana. Right? Mahayana shuru hota hai, and gradually these early 17, some of these 17 went into Mahayana. And then you have this Mahayana school, which is very important. It starts earlier, but then becomes important later and spreads, as I said, to Afghanistan, Central Asia, China, Japan, India. So the things in China and Japan, East Asia are part of Mahayana. Chan Buddhism, etc., etc., Jogjichiren Buddhism, Chingon, all these things are schools of Mahayana, which is out of our study. For us, Mahayana, Bodhisattva, etc. is here. Now, after Mahayana, we have third school that becomes important. That is the latest school, that is Vajrayana. It is Tantric Buddhism. तंत्र मंत्र ओम भग्नि भागोदरी भट स्वाहा टाइप भी इसमें चलता है, मंत्र तंत्र, बट दे डोंट यूज दिस मंत्र स्पेसिफिकली, आई एम जस्ट लुकिंग, बट यू हैव विल सी वज्रयान, वज्रयान बिकम्स इम्पोर्टेंट. एंड वेन वी रीच द अर्ली मेडिवल का खत्म होता है, मिडिवल शुरू होता है, बुद्धिज्म डिसअपियर फ्रॉम इंडिया लार्ज. सो दिस इज द अर्ली स्कूल्स इनिशियली, देन वी हैव थेरवाद, महायान एंड वज्रयान. Now inside early Buddhist school we have 18 schools. In time Mahayana we have two important schools that we need to know, and inside Vajrayana again we have two three important parts which we need to know. So the questions are coming from here. Questions historically have been coming from here, and latest they started asking questions last year from here as well. So we need to know all of them. Let us move on then. Let us go next. The first council. Immediately after Buddha's life, 3 months after the Buddha died, the first council is called. And the meeting was called by a person called Mahakashyapa. Mahakashyapa, because he felt that people are forgetting Dhamma, Dhamma is getting corrupted, now we need to organize them into single body of thought. Buddha to chala gaya. Jab Muhammad Paigambar the, unke chal basne ke baad, logon ne hadith wagaire bana ke kiya ki bhai, kya hoga? Hadith apne agar padhe honge kabhi. ट्रेडिशन इन हादिर भाई की कौन सा सिंह असली है, कौन सा मौजू है. मौजू इज अरबिक वर्ड फॉर करप्ट. बट एनी वे, सो 3 months आफ्टर द बुद्धा डाइड दिस फर्स्ट काउंसिल वॉज कॉल्ड बिकॉज ही फेल्ट दैट धम्म एंड विनय वुड बी करप्टेड एंड वुड नॉट सर्वाइव द मंक्स, एंड इफ द मंक्स आर फ्री टू इंटरप्रिट देम एज दे वॉन्ट देन इट विल लूज द कोहेरेंस ऑफ बुद्धिस्ट संघ. सो द टू थिंग्स विच आर मोर मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट आउटकम्स ऑफ दिस फर्स्ट काउंसिल are Vinaya Pitaka and Sutta Pitaka. So Vinaya Pitaka were formalized. One of the most important monks, Upali. Upali recited Vinayas from his memory because he was associated with Buddha from the beginning. As he recited, it was noted down and formalized. So Vinaya were formed. Vinaya Pitaka was formed as the outcome of the first council. And similarly, Ananda, who was the other associate of Buddha, and memorized all the discourses of Buddha. So he talked about them, he recited them, it was noted down. So we have Sutta Pitaka coming out as well. Major parts of Sutta Sutra, many sutras, Sutta Pitaka coming out as well. Vinaya Pitaka and Sutta Pitaka were formalized as the outcome of the first call. That is enough for us. The founder, the president is Mahakashyap, and it happened very soon after Buddha's Mahaparinirvana. Is it clear? Chalo, aage chalte hain. Then you have 100 years gone, about 100 years gone since the death of Buddha, and we have second council. And now there is a debate that is arising. It is called the response to dispute over Vinaya. And what is that dispute? The dispute is happening over the 10 Vinaya rules. See, monks should monks behave. See, Bhagavan ke bare mein dispute unka hai nahi shuru mein. It starts with discipline and not with the doctrine. That is an important thing. If you go to Christianity, the dispute starts with doctrine and then goes to discipline. Here, it's exactly opposite. Nonetheless, कौन से discipline के बारे में लोगों को परेशानी है? जो monks हैं, बोल रहे हैं हमें discipline नहीं follow करना. वो है storing salt in horn, eating after midday, eating once, going to villages for alms, eating sour milk after once meal. Ultimately, gold and silver is the most thing. How they should they deal in money? Buddha says, aparigraha. You should not possess money. At least not more than what you require minimally. There should be no material attachment. But many monks have started dealing in money. Aise aane lage, because they are giving wisdom to people. The Sangha is getting established at such a... Sangha is never in the forest, by the way. The Sangha is also never in the city. Yahan bhi madhyam marg hai. Sangha is just outside the city boundary. They are dependent on city for arms. They come to city, and whenever you go to place, newer place, you go as a trader. So for traders, the sangha there becomes the important place of resting, getting local intelligence, having a people who can read and write and keep accounts. So as sangha spread, the economy spread, and as the economy spread, sangha spread. And on the roots of economy, you see many sanghas getting established. Uttarapur, Dakshinapur, Western Ghats, everywhere. We have this rock cut architecture and old stupas and sanghas. This is the trade routes of India. Mercantile community. Jaise economy of India was expanding after Mauryan era, then economy became global economy. एंड इट वॉज डोमिनेटिंग द वर्ल्ड कम्प्लीटली. तो इंडिया इतना एक्सपोर्ट किया, आज अमेरिका एक्सपोर्ट करता है, अमेरिका इज इकोनॉमिक पावर, सो वी कंज्यूम अमेरिकन कल्चर एज वेल. यू सी फैमिली मैन 2.0, वी वेयर जीन्स, राइट, अमेजोन देखते हैं, अमेरिकन कल्चर कंज्यूम कर रहे हैं बिकॉज वो पावर है, इकोनॉमिक पावर है और फिर कल्चरल पावर भी है. Similarly, in the post-Mauryan times, India was economic power and also cultural power, and the epitome of that cultural power is Buddhism, and Buddhism is accepted by entire Asia at that time. So, economy and Buddhism are in the same. But anyway, let us not go into that debate or that angle. Point is that economy and Sangha are closely connected, so many monks want to participate in the economic operation. The old school people say, no? बुद्धा ने कहा था पैसे नहीं चाहिए आपको, क्या करना है, बस संघा के लिए कर दो, रखो बाकी छोड़ो. दिस डिबेट गोइंग ऑन, आउटकम क्या होता है, अल्टीमेटली यूनानिमस डिसीजन नॉट टू रिलैक्स एनी ऑफ द रूल्स एंड द सेंसुअल बिहेवियर ऑफ द मंक्स हाइलाइटेड द 10 पॉइंट्स. सो अल्टीमेटली दे डिसाइड दे विल नॉट रिलैक्स द विनया रूल. व्हाट हैड हैपेंड एक्चुअली, बुद्धा जस्ट बिफोर परिनिर्वाण, बिफोर हिज डेथ, हैड टोल्ड टू आनंदा दैट community, the Sangha community may unanimously relinquish the minor rules of Vinaya. Now, which rules are minor, which are major, that is never settled. So now it is upon the community to decide which is the minor rule and therefore which can be modified. ठीक है, तो dispute होना लाजमी है, तभी वो चलेगा यार. आप नए समाज में हो, नए locality में हो, नया structure है, you have to keep changing. But people who want to change are not allowed to change, the older people say. So, उससे दिक्कत हो गई एंड संघा गॉट डिवाइडेड, इट गॉट ब्रोकन ऑफ इन टू पार्ट्स इन द, दैट इज कॉल्ड फर्स्ट स्किज्म. द फर्स्ट स्किज्म इन संघा इज महासंघिका एंड स्थविरवाद. महासंघिका आर द मेजॉरिटी, द लार्जर मेजॉरिटी, एंड स्थविरवाद आर द एल्डर, ओल्ड स्कूल ऑर्थोडॉक्स पीपल हु डू नॉट वॉन्ट चेंज इन द रूल. महासंघिका वॉन्ट रूल्स टू बी रिलैक्स्ड. संघिक महासंघिका से दिस इज अवर मेजोरिटी एंड वी टेक डिसीजंस बाय मेजोरिटी. स्थविरवाद से इट्स नॉट पार्लियामेंट्री डेमोक्रेसी, द रूल्स हैव देयर ओन सैंक्टिटी, सो यू हैव टू फॉलो द ओल्डर रूल्स बिकॉज दे आर द कोर ऑफ विनय. डिबेट होता है, सो यू हैव दिस थिंग. सो महासंघिका बोल, सो दिस डिपार्चर हैज हैपेंड ओवर विनय रूल्स एंड नॉट डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ बुद्धा, डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ एनीथिंग एल्स, व्हाट विनय. यू हैव महासंघिका एंड स्थविरा. That is the first important thing for us to know. Let us move on. The difference between Mahasanghika and Sthavira. So Sthavira held firmly to the old monastic ideal. And Arhat. So Arhat is an important term. See, if you are a Buddha, you can't be. Buddha is only one. According to old school. So you attain enlightenment, you become Buddha, you get Nirvana. But if you are a common person like you and me, and you relinquish life, you join Sangha, and then you follow all the path and successfully you become enlightened. You get Nirvana. Then you are not called Buddha, you are called Arhat or Arihan. We discussed that. So the highest objective for people when they join Buddha, according to old school, is that you become Arhat. Arhat is the center, that is the thing that one has to achieve. And then you get Nibbana. And Tripitaka ke bare mein confused inka tha. And they consider Buddha as the great teacher, but a mortal being. On the other hand, Mahasanghika introduced certain changes, and these changes are not only in Vinaya rules anymore. So changes are moving from Vinaya into idea of Buddha, idea of God. Buddhism mein God nahi hai. Matlab Buddhism mein God hai, but God is irrelevant. Buddha is actually silent on God, if you see. But now what is happening? Mahasanghika says non-arhat monks, the monks who are not in discipline completely, the monks who are not enlightened, because we are getting more popular, let us allow people who do not follow all the norms to be part of our Sangha. For example, Indian army. If you want to fight a war, you want soldiers, but people do not fit the physical criteria, will you admit them? Nahi karte. Many of the posts at colonel and higher level are empty in army because they are not able to find suitable people. They are not downgrading their benchmark standard criteria for admission, even though there is need. Mahayana saying, doesn't matter, let us change your requirement, bring it down, let us allow other people, will become more popular, will spread. Let us expand first, they will think of some other thing. So non-arhat monks, but Sthavirvadis don't want that. Mahayana, not Mahayana, sorry, Mahasanghika. Mahayana is yet to emerge, Mahasanghika. Mahasangha starts a deification of Buddha. They say Buddha is not only a teacher, Buddha is also God. This element of Mahasangha later on becomes part of Mahayana as well. And then focus on attaining full awareness. So other things are there. So these are the first two factions, Thaviravada and Mahasangha. And that first two factions emerge after the second council. Now we have the third council. Third council is called by Samrat Ashok. Sakkavatti Dhammiko Dhamma Raja Ashok. ठीक है. So Devanamati ya Piyadasi. So here you have a person called Mogaliputta Tissa, who is the chairman or the president, and the patron of the third council is Ashok. And यहाँ पे again the same dispute is happening, but now you see dispute is on the two levels, both disciplinary level and Vinaya level and doctrinal level both. What has happened is that Ashok is the great patron of Buddhism. He is lavishing them with lot of money. He is building stupas after stupa. 84,000 stupas he is supposed to have built across India. So इतना पैसा आ रहा है. People want to see, live their life and join Sangha and get all this free money. Lot of people start entering Sangha and they don't care about Buddhism. Bas free mein paisa mil raha hai. So older people in Sangha get agitated. Ye kya chal raha hai? We have to stop it somewhere. Theek hai. So dikkat shuru ho jati hai. So to stop this move, to stop this corruption in the Buddhism, to purify the movement and purify the Sangha and reject the people who hold heretical views, the third council is called. अशोका के बारे में कहानियां बड़ी फेमस है. इवन सपोज यू हैव किल्ड द हेड्स ऑफ हंड्रेड्स एंड हंड्रेड्स ऑफ मॉन्क्स. वी वोंट गो देयर. दीज आर जस्ट स्टोरीज इन ट्रेडिशन एंड द डॉक्ट्रिनल डिफरेंसेस एज वेल. सो भगवान कैसे होता है, बुद्धा कौन है, होली सत्ता है, देयर आर मेनी डिफरेंसेस दैट आर कमिंग अप. सो द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द काउंसिल दैट इज मोगलीपुत्र तिस्सा, ही राइट्स अ बुक एंड द नेम ऑफ दैट बुक इज कथावस्तु और कथावस्तु, which becomes a part of Abhidhamma Pitaka we talked about. And in that book, he entertains all such questions, heretical questions, and he counters them one by one by. He says, this faction is calling for this, but this is the wrong view, this is the right view. This other faction is calling for this, wrong view, right view. So he settles the score of all the factions. Ultimately, the council people adopt the viewpoint put forth by Mogaliputta Tissa and Kathavattu, and all the heretical monks are expelled. Now here you don't have two sides like Mahasangika Saviravada. You have many more sides and all of them have their heretical points and all of them are expelled. So Kathavattu is important outcome of this thing. Second thing is the expelled people will start their own Sanghas now. You have many factions coming up in Ashoka's time. The Sangha is fractured completely. And here we have 18, that is the great schism of Jogula, of Dekhenge. And there are many other outcomes of the third council as well. So let us see them. The first outcome is the compilation of Abhidhamma Pitaka. We have already seen the contents of Abhidhamma Pitaka, 7 books hai usme. It's Abhidhamma way or methodology, and not all people equally consider it object worthy of reverence. So you have Saviravadin, Sarvastivadin, who are the sect of Saviravadin. They have a great contribution in the compilation and composition of Abhidhamma Pitaka. On the other hand, many people in Mahasangika say this is nonsense. Now Mahasangika is right long ago. The only thing that is existing today is Mahayana, which has combined many elements of Mahasangika. So Mahayana people also reject Abhidhamma Pitaka. Anyway, so Abhidhamma Pitaka is the first outcome. Second outcome is that Buddha sent emissaries and monks across India and world to spread the message of Dhamma. And that decision was taken in the third council. In the council, Ashoka sent. And Ashoka announced that he is sending him to whom. So we have the list given over here. Name of the missionary, name of the country to which the person went, and the name of the school that he founded there. So we have, for example, Mahinda and Sangamitra, the last one. Mahinda and Sangamitra are brothers and sisters. So let us move ahead. So these 18 sects are very important. Unfortunately, the history of this 18th century is very complicated and checkered. And with the exception of Theravada, none of these schools have survived. We'll go to the specific only. Firstly, the differences that are occurring are no more only differences over discipline or Vinaya. They are differences over a conception of reality. This idea of reality is philosophically called as ontology. Don't worry about this word. It's just a fancy word. It's about reality. How do you perceive reality? What do you think of reality? So in Buddhism, we have seen there is anitya, anicca, anatma. So anitya, anatta, dhamma, this tilakhana is the starting of ontology in Buddhism. What is the reality? There is no permanent self. There is no atma. Everything is dukkha. That is where it began. Then you have nidan and we have links and all those things. So it's an idea. Now they have started disputing this idea of reality. Kisme kya hai, kisme kya nahi hai. And that's why we see there is a dispute. And by the time you reach Ashoka's time, the dispute has spread and splintered into 18 facts. Now, these are what we'll see is. We have seen that we have Thaviravada and Mahasanghika. Now, this Thaviravada and Mahasanghika itself splintered into various sub factions. We have Sangha, we have Thaviravada. So, we have sub schools of Thavira and we have sub schools of Mahasanghika. That is what the question that we asked last year was based upon. We needed to know which of these sub schools belong to Buddhism and which of them belong to Jainism. And because in Jainism also, we do not have only Digambar, Shvetambar. Inside Digambar, we have various sections. Inside Shvetambar, we have various sections. Vishvapanthi, Therapanthi, etc. There are many things. Then even we have a Gachcha type system in the medieval times. So, a point is that UPSC gave some of those terms and some of these terms, put them together, combined, mixed, and then asked us identify which is Buddhist, which is Jain. Now, this question might sound very difficult because you don't have to study it. Anyway, let us understand. So, these are the factions of Thaviravada. The first faction is Pudgalavada, second is Sarvastivada, and Vajjavada. We do not need to know the doctrinal concepts or concepts of reality and differences between them for this. Not even the philosophy option people read that. जरूरत नहीं है बट जस्ट फॉर द सेक ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड गिविंग सम कॉन्टेक्स्ट आई हैव एडेड वन और टू लाइंस ओनली पुद्गलवाद इट कंसीडर्ड दैट व्हाइल देयर इज नो आत्मन देयर इज दिस पुद्गला पर्सन और सत्व सो इट अंडरस्टैंड देयर इज नो आत्मन बुद्धा सेड नो आत्मन नो आत्मन बट देयर इज अ पर्सन इट इज अ रियल पर्सन तो उल्टा कर दिया बुद्धा को थोड़ा सा ही लेकिन उनका अपना स्टाइल था दिस वॉज अ वेरी पॉपुलर स्कूल फॉर सब स्कूल ऑफ थवीरा during Harsha time, that is 6th century, 7th century era, and it lasted till the early medieval. And amongst all these Thavira subsects, it was the most popular subject in India by population size. So, isko sabse zyada log follow karte the amongst these Thavira Buddhists. Then we have second school, that is Sarvastivadi. Sarva Astin Vadin. They say everything exists. They say Atman doesn't exist, but there is a person. They say everything is Sarvastivadi, Sarva Asti Vadi. They rejected the Pudgalatma but accepted something called as Dharmatma. Dharmatma is not a Bollywood movie, by the way. Dharma Atma. But anyway, then we have Vibhajyavada. Vibhajyavada, Vibhajya is division or distinguishing A from B, separating, Vibhajan Karna. So Vibhajanvada said ki bhai, neither this is true nor this is true, and neither all dharmas exist. Neither all dharmas are equally. Dharmas is a word for reality as well. By the way, that is important. Buddhist dharma, dhamma, that is Buddhist law. But when you use it in plural, dharmas, dhammas, it means the aspects of reality. The Buddhist conception of real dhammas. Alag word hai. Matlab word ek hi hai, concept alag. So Vibhajyavada says there are some dhammas which exist and some dharmas which don't exist. I will divide them into two parts. So we have Mahajan, Vibhajyavada. ठीक है, और विभाज्यवाद जो है उसके भी सब स्कूल आए एंड फ्रॉम दैट अल्टीमेटली इमर्ज थेरवाद और दैट इज अवर हीनयान. तो हवीरवाद गॉट डिवाइड इनटू थ्री पार्ट ऑफ विच वन इज विभाज्यवाद विच गॉट डिवाइड इनटू मल्टीपल पार्ट ऑफ विच वन इज हीनयान. तो लेट अस कम ओवर हियर फर्स्ट. यू सी दिस इज हवीरवाद आउट ऑफ द टू ग्रेट फैक्शन. हवीरवाद सेंटर्ड इनटू उद्गलवाद विभाज्यवाद एंड सर्वस्थीवाद. And out of this Vibhajyavad, you have two schools emerging, and of that one is Theravada. Theravada is about Hinayana. So in that sense, you can say Hvirvada is related to Theravada. But Pudgalavada got divided into four schools. Sarvastivada divided into three, four schools of its own. Now all of these schools have vanished. They are lost. But some of the elements of this school were absorbed by Mahayana later on. We have Vatsipriya or Sammitiya, we have Sautrantika, we have Vaibhashika. These schools contributed some of its element into Mahayana. It influenced the emergence and initial development of Mahayana. So the point is, hota kya hai? Tradition says, especially the Savira tradition says, ki we are the original inheritor of the Avirvad. Because in Thavir, which is Sanskrit word, the same word for Thera in Pali. Our name is also the same. We are the original. We are the original. We are the pure. So we are superior. That is what these Thavir Theravadi people say. And this is the region where Hinayan spread. Even today it is there in these regions. From Burma or Myanmar, we have Vipassana movement coming up in modern times. It has become very famous in India, across India in the last 20-25 years, started by Goenka. Goenka was the president of Burma. Anyway, so traditional account says that Hvirvad and the Theravad, that is Hinayan, are the one and the same. They even wrote their famous book called Deepa Vamsha. Deepa is Dvipa. Dvipa in Sanskrit, in Pali become Deepa. So it's the genealogy, Vamshavali, genealogy of the island, Dvipa Vamsha, genealogy of the island. It's the story of the initial arrival of Buddhism to island, that is Sri Lanka, and how it developed gradually. So that story is also because that the Theravada is popular over this story of Theravada. And it claims that it is the same thing as Hvirvada. But now we know that it is not so. They are very similar. And one is emerged out of the other, but they are not identical. Hvirvada led to Vibhajyavada, led to Theravada. That is the connection. Ye samajh mein aaya aap tak? Is it clear so far? Theek hai? Okay. Let us move on to the next part. The poem, you can find Deepa Vamsha. These 17 sects are schismatic. Ye sab tukde phukde kar dete hai, jhagadte rehte hai aapas mein. They are not following the unity. Only one is non-schismatic, my akela. With the non-schismatic sect are all 18 in all. It's a samaya hai. Like a great banyan tree, the Theravadin is supreme. So they try to put their own supremacy among the 17 other sects. Okay. Now, this is about Hvirvada and its sub-factions, and from that sub-faction sound, Theravadin or Hinayan emerge. Right? Now we come to Mahasamgika. What happened to Mahasamgika? Mahasamgika also got splintered into various subsects of its own. One subsect is called Chaitika. Chaitika, you know the word Chaitya, Chaitya Vihar, right? Chaitika is the people who carve those Chaitas. They call Chaitika. So these are the people who belong to a sect which was famous for Ajanta, Ellora, Karla, etc., which was later on absorbed into Mahayana. Mahayana hi samjho isko temporarily, but initially it was a different sect, Chaitika sect. Then you have another sect called Lokottarvada. Loka Uttar, that is more than this lok. Ye lok mein jo nahi hai usse bhi aage jaake jo hai, so transcendent. So they call off Buddha as person who is transcendental. He is not a person from this land, this earth, this world. He comes from the world beyond, Lokottarvada. And they introduced they wrote a book called Mahavastu, which is their first Vinaya text. And in that Mahavastu, you see many episodes related to past and present Buddha. So Buddha ki biography banna shuru ho jati hai. ठीक है, यहाँ से बुद्धा की बायोग्राफी की डिटेल्स यहाँ से पता चलते हैं, पहले नहीं पता था. देन यू हैव थर्ड सेट कॉल्ड कुक्कू टीका और गोकू टीका. इट वॉज फ्रॉम बिहार अगेन एंड इट वॉज वेरी सिमिलर टू लोकोच प्रवास. इट एडेड हिज ओन क्रोनोलॉजिकल एलिमेंट. वी डोंट नीड टू गो इनटू डिटेल्स बट नॉनदलेस. एंड एक का व्यवहारिका अगेन हू फोकस्ड ऑन द ट्रांसेंडेंटल बीइंग ऑफ बुद्धा. सो डोंट वरी अबाउट द डिटेल्स. वॉट वी नीड टू नो इज महासंगिका प्रिंटेड इन टू मेनी पार्ट ऑफ विच चैतिका लोकोत्तरवाद कुक्कुटिका ये सेम थिंग एज गोकुलिका एंड एका व्यवहारिका. दीज आर फोर पार्ट. दैट्स ऑल वी नीड टू नो. एंड इफ यू सी मेनी लेटर कमेंटेटर्स इन बुद्धिज्म फ्रॉम द मेडिवल टाइम इवन गो टू द एक्सटेंट एंड सेइंग कि दीज आर द नेम्स ऑफ द सेम थिंग, दे आर नॉट डिफरेंट नेम्स. तो वो आपस में पहले से ही बना के बैठे कि हम एक ही है, अलग नहीं. एनी वे, सो लेट अस मूव ऑन. नो हाउ डिड महायान कम आउट ऑफ महासंगिका, तो उसके बारे में भी यहाँ पे है कि ट्रेडिशनल अकाउंट ऑफ महायान एंड मॉडर्न अकाउंट क्या फर्क है. व्हाट इज द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन महायान एंड महासंगिका. वी हैव सीन द रिलेशन बिटवीन स्थविरवाद एंड थेरवाद. लेट अस सी द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन महासंगिका एंड महायान. सो ट्रेडिशनसेस ऑफ ट्रेडिशन ऑफ महायान देमसेल्फ जैसे दे इमर्ज फ्रॉम महासंगिका. बट वी नो एज अ मैटर ऑफ फैक्ट द मेनी इंपॉर्टेंट इनिशियल इंपॉर्टेंट बुक्स ऑफ महायान एग्जिस्टेड इन पैरेलल टू महासंगिका. So, initial text. So, these two schools were distinct initially, although they are similar, but distinct and they influenced each other. Mahasangika khatam hoke Mahayan tayar nahi hua. Ya Mahasangika ne aratura tapna naam change karke, now I will be called Mahayan. No. Initially, there are Mahasangika sects, Mahayan has started, and then these sects influenced each other, and ultimately, many of them combine into Mahayan. That is the story. Clear ho raha hai, samajh mein aa raha hai? क्लियर?
यस सर.
ओके, ठीक है. सेक्टेरियन मूवमेंट. सो महायान के बारे में देयर आर मेनी, विल सी महायान सेपरेटली फॉर सम टाइम, इट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. महायान के बारे में इट हैज रिलैक्स द ओरिजिनल बुद्धिज्म को लार्ज एक्सटेंड. इट हैज बीन रिवर्टेड द एंटायर बुद्धिज्म, तो मतलब उल्टा करते बुद्धिज्म को. विल सी दैट व्हाई. बट दैट व्हाई डिड इट हैपन, दैट इज द क्वेश्चन. एंड ट्रेडिशन सेज दैट इट वॉज इंस्टिगेटेड by a devotional practices at respect of common people. Everybody wanted to join. Chalo hame jana hai chhod, lekin hum so popular, that is at the mass level, devotional practices, bhakti element, devotion of common people. Uske wajah se aaya hoga. So it society ne hi usko change kar diya. But if you see, it is not so. It is actually the ideas and teaching originated not in the society, but in the monks, in the people who had already joined monks. विद इन द संघा इटसेल्फ. होता क्या है कि संघा इज फोकसिंग ऑन विनया, नॉट एज मच, बट नॉट एज मच ऑन डॉक्ट्रिन. सो यू एंड मी आर इन द सेम संघा, वी लिव इन द सेम हॉस्टेल ऑफ मंथ्स, वी कैरी द सिमिलर एक्टिविटीज एज वेल, बट द वे यू वर्शिप बुद्धा एंड द वे आई फॉलो बुद्धिज्म मे बी डिफरेंट. दैट इज कंप्लीटली अलाउड. इफ यू गो टू चर्च इट इज नॉट अलाउड. इफ यू बिलोंग द सेम चर्च यू हैव टू फॉलो द सेम डॉक्ट्रिन. Buddhism focuses more on Vinaya than on doctrine. So gradually what happened in the same Sangha, people following the same Vinaya may have different worshipping practices. So from that emerged Maya. So it was not something that aapas mein mile jhagda kiye, tera mera alag, aapka rasta, tula alag, khana alag, kitchen alag. No, that is not the way it happened. So it is not a Christian way of ism. Sangha Bheda is a gradual process. Even when Mahayan, Pahajan and Yuansang came to India, many, many centuries after Mahayana was established, they saw in the same Sangha, people of Mahayana and other sects are living together harmoniously. They are not fighting because they respect each other's way of worship. Okay. So this is how interfaith religion, sectarian, maybe you have seen, sectarianism is not so bad. We respect each other's sects. So anyway, so there was no major schism as such. It happened very gradually. Over centuries, that is the point. So you see what is happening now. We have Shakyamuni Buddha, original Sangha. Then we have, by the time of Ashoka, 18 sects of, and then we have out of that coming Avirvad, which becomes important, which of which one from Vibhajyavad is Theravada. It goes South India and Southeast Asia. From Mahasangika section and some parts of Sarvastivada, etc., Vaibhashika, Sutrantika, etc., we have Mahayana coming up. And we have independently coming up of Vajrayana. So, Theravada, Mahayana, and Vajrayana. Now, this is what is the early schism for us, of which Mahayana is important and Vajrayana is important. Theravada we have already seen. Then we have the fourth concept. Now, Ashoka's time is gone, many centuries have gone in between, and now we have Kushanas came to India. The fourth council happens in the first century, BCE or CE, depending on which one you call as the fourth council. There are two fourth councils, one happening in North India, one in the South. We need to know the story of both of them. One happening in the South is of the Theravadins, because Theravadins are popular in South India, especially in Sri Lanka. So the place called Anuradhapur, which was the capital there, is the place where you have the Theravadin assembly. It is Theravadins call it their council. So they count this council as the fourth council. It was headed under the patronage of Valagamma. And वहाँ पे सीधी बात थी, ऐसी कोई bad season आया था, there was hunger, there was poverty, there was famine, not enough to eat. So many monks died. And when many monks died, the tradition was in the oral culture. व्यास पे बैठे थे. If you are reading Quran, you remember Quran, you become Hafiz. You have to orally you have to remember entire Quran. When you remember it, you become a safeguard person. You save it, you give it a body form in your own shape, so you are keeping it safe. So muhafiz rakh rahe ho, so aap hafiz ho. Same case was with the Buddhism. Sab oral tha, Vedic religion same oral sab ratna hai acche se. Theek hai. So, but when they saw ki famine is coming and people might die and the tradition might disappear, or no, let us sit together and write it down, so that even if we die, the tradition continues. But this is the fourth council for Theravadins in Sri Lanka. It's a simple thing, nothing much. In North India, a century later, we have fourth council of Mahayana. The first three councils dono ke saath mein hai, fourth council dono ka alag alag hai. And it is called by Kanishka. And yahan pe bhi major cheez hoti hai, Kanishka calls the council. The person who is presiding over the council, what is his name? Vasubandhu, one of the great scholars. No, sorry, not Vasubandhu. What is the name?
Vasumitra,
right. Vasubandhu, yes. Vasumitra, I got confused. Okay, that confusion might happen also. Vasumitra, and he is supported by second in command. And what is the name of that person?
Ashwaghosha,
right. Oh, you have access to next slide as well, right? I forgot. Ashwaghosha. So they compile all the books together and they translate into Sanskrit. So here we see the movement of translation from all the old Prakrits and Palis and majorly Palis into Sanskrit that is happening. And Sanskrit mein translation ho raha hai, matlab this is Mahayana supported Sanskrit. It adopted Sanskrit as the major language. High language, because Mahayana sutras, Mahayana doctrines, Mahayana concepts are so complicated to express them in a language that can carry that complication. If you want to read law at the higher level, you have to read French. Because the law developed as it developed, international law especially, continentally developed for over the last 300 years, it is French that suits law. Let's say if you want to read poetry, Gitanjali, you have to read Bengali, Gitanjali. Similarly, Sanskrit was the language which was suitable for such higher kind of scholarly, minutiae debates. So they translated everything into Sanskrit. That is the outcome, one important outcome of the fourth council. Now it was held in Kashmir or Jalandhar, that is the question. Nobody knows the exact date as well, but it's okay. Ashwaghosha is the most important person. We study him in literature as well, when we study the history of Indian Sanskrit classical literature, especially Sanskrit drama. Theatre ki tradition mein Ashwaghosha is the oldest extant material that we have. He wrote three books, Buddha Charita, Saundara Ananda and Sariputta Prakarana. The theme of all these three books is conversion to Buddhism. So, uske bare mein story badi famous hai. Kanishka, when he came from outside India, settled in Afghanistan, attacked India, went into heart of Gangetic Basin, he even राइट टू कॉन्कर बनारस. एट दैट टाइम बनारस को उसने घेरा डाल दिया, उसकी सेना आ गई थी. किंग ऑफ बनारस ने यार प्लीज आई गिव यू सम रैंसम, हमारी जान बख्शो, लीव अस. तो वॉट कैन ही गिव टू द कनिष्का हू इज ऑलरेडी अ वेरी रिच पर्सन एंड अ ग्रेट रूलर. सो द रूलर ऑफ वाराणसी ऑफर्ड टू थिंग्स. ही ऑफर्ड द बाउल, द बेगिंग बाउल ऑफ बुद्धा, इन विच बुद्धा यूज्ड टू गो एंड बेग अराउंड आर्म्स के लिए भिक्षा मांगता था, वो बाउल दे दिया उसने कनिष्का को. एंड द सेकंड थिंग दैट ही गेव वाज दिस स्कॉलर अश्वघोषा. ही इज द ग्रेटेस्ट स्कॉलर, टेक इट हिम विद, टेक हिम विद यू. अश्वघोषा जॉइन द कनिष्क, कनिष्का द रेटिन्यू. He went to Mathura and then Peshawar, etc. So he was the deputy for the fourth council. Anyway, come to the summary. Summary of the Buddhist council. First, second, third, fourth. Around 100 BC, 383 BC, 250 BC, and maybe 72, 80, we do not know. Place, Rajagruha, Vaishali, Pataliputra, Kundalwan, Kashmir, or Anuradhapura. Decided by Mahakashyapa, Savaka, Sabbakami, Mohinputra Kishka, and Vasumitra. Patronage of the king, Ajatashatru, Alak, Ashoka, Ashoka, and Kanishka. And these are the many first important things. Now you need to remember this table by heart. It is very important. Okay? There is no way around. You have to remember this table by heart. But what happens is generally questions are asked about Saptavatarantika, this and that. But what we do ultimately is only this much. So this much is given in all the books, but this much is not enough. We have to go through. Okay?